Hey guys, it's Vignesh from CodeAndroid. In previous tutorial, we have seen the introduction of room database. Now, we'll see how to create a database in room. To demonstrate this, I'm going to use the weather project which we have created in our MBVM series. We have all the models, also known as DTO, used in this project present inside model package. In this, we want to create location and consolidated weather as table. To create a table in room database, we need to add an annotation to the class as @entity. For that, we need to add room dependency first. So, I'm copying the dependency and pasting it in our app level gradle file. Here, we are using KAPT, Kotlin Annotation Processing Tool. So, adding Kotlin KAPT plugin. Let's sync the project. To make this class as table, adding annotation as @entity. By adding this annotation, room will understand that it should create a table for this class. We can create a primary key for a table in two ways. We can add an annotation called @primaryKey for a variable in the class, which makes that field as primary key for the table. Sometime we want to make primary key as auto-generated. To do that, we need to pass auto-generate equals to true like this. In some case, we might need to create composite primary key. In that scenario, we need to pass primary keys as an array inside the entity. Inside the array, we need to pass primary key columns. In our case, WOE ID is unique, so I'm making that field as primary key. Let's do the same for consolidated weather class, adding entity annotation and making one of the field as primary key. To keep all the room files, creating a package called room, inside creating a class called weather. For room database, we need an abstract class, so making this class as abstract, which extends room database. To make this as database, we need to add annotation called @database. Inside, we need to pass two values, database version, in this case 1, and tables for the database. In this case, we want location and consolidated weather tables inside this database, so I'm passing those as entity. Finally, we need to create the database object. To do that, creating a companion object, inside creating a function called get, which takes application as parameter. Because to create a database object, we need a context. Our repository has an application context, that's why I'm adding application here. This function should return the database. Sorry, this naming is making some confusion. So, I'm changing this class name and return type as weather database. Inside here, we need to create the database and return it. Room.DatabaseBuilder. Inside, we need to pass three parameter: context, database class, and database name. In our case, I'm keeping the database name as weather. Finally, building the database. Now, creating the database object in our splash screen. Now we'll launch the application. You can see after launching the application, in our device file explorer, we are not able to see any database. Because until we do any read or write operation, the database will not get created. Now, we'll see how to create a DAO, so that we can do some read or write operation. For DAO, we need an interface, so right click on the room package and select Kotlin file or class. Here, selecting the kind as interface and giving the name as weather DAO. To make this interface as a DAO, adding annotation called @DAO. I want to insert the location received from the API into the database, so creating a function called insertLocation, inside passing list of location as parameter. We want to insert this data into database, so adding the annotation called @insert. Also, we need to tell what to do when duplicate comes. For our application, we need to replace the record, so I'm giving onConflict strategy as replace. To read the data from the table, I want to create a search function, because in search activity, we will search for the city. So I'm creating a function called getLocation, inside passing the search string as parameter. This function should return list of location which matches the search string. To read the data from the database, we need to use query. So adding the annotation as @query, inside passing the query. Select star from. You can see I'm making some mistake in spelling and the IDE is giving the error. This won't happen when we use SQLite helper. In our query, I need to use like case so that all the location which contains the characters will be listed. So adding like condition. Here we need to pass the search string. To do that, we need to use colon and variable name. Now we want to call this insertLocation function when we get the response from the API. So opening the repository, this is the place where we get the response, so we need to insert the data into database here. But we can't insert the data from main thread, so I'm creating an async task called insertLocationData and implementing the member of async task. We want to insert list of location, so I'm adding list of location and application as a parameter, because to create the database we need the application context. We need to bind the database and DAO. To do that, we need to create an abstract function and return the correct DAO. Make sure that you have created the function as abstract and returning the correct DAO. Now, inside doin background, we can create the database object. We need to pass the application object to create the database, but we can't access it in doin background. To make it accessible, I'm changing the constructor parameter as value for the class. You can see now the error is gone in doin background. From this database, getting the DAO and calling insertLocation. We don't have any value to return, so making doin background return type as nullable and returning null. Just to check getLocation function, calling the function after inserting the data and logging the result into logget. Finally, calling the async task. Sorry, I need to pass the search string with percentage for filter, so I'm adding percentage on both sides. Now we'll launch the application. You can see here I'm searching for BA and we are getting the result which has more than 5 items. Now when we check our logcat, we have only 4 items listed which has BAN in its name. Like this, we can store and retrieve the data from database without writing much of a code using Room database. That's all for this tutorial, guys. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If you have any doubts, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.